Quite a long time ago, I published a circuit of a sine wave oscillator. And it was viewed many, many times, thousands of times. But when I got two complaints about that circuit. And perhaps I was lucky in those days. Because I got a second complaint about this circuit, and I want to give the link to that earlier circuit, and I got today another complaint that this circuit didn't work. And well, I've tested it in those days, and in the video you see that it works. But perhaps there was a kind of lucky combination, and especially in relation between the voltage divider here, the bias of the transistor, say a lucky voltage divider here, a lucky exactly the good voltage here on the base of the transistor that did the job, and that's why it worked. So I rebuilt the circuit today and found that it didn't work, and I'm absolutely sure it has everything to do with the bias of the transistor. So these two resistors form a voltage divider. That voltage divider is very, very critical, and especially when we are talking about sine wave oscillators. So away with this circuit, and today I made a new circuit. And here is the schematic. And I made now the bias of the transistor oscillator variable, so that you can set it to the exact position where the circuit oscillates. That has something to do with the supply voltage. And I tested it, and it surely works between 7 and 10 volts. You get a little bit distortion on 10 volts, and it works, of course, only on a fixed frequency, and it is in this case 760 Hz. Transistor must have an amplification factor of approximately 250. When it doesn't have that amplification factor, it could be that it doesn't work. There's also a relation between the amplification factor and the bias. So transistors with a lower amplification factor, say 100, can work when the bias is set to another position, the potentiometer, and that's a trimmer in this case. Here is the circuit. And here is the trimmer that sets the oscillation, and I will try to demonstrate that. I'm going to turn now with the screwdriver, the trimmer, and we are on 7.4 volts. And here is the waveform. It's pure, but you can surely see that when I turn I touch the trimmer, so this is 50 hertz of my hand. That's the effect on the waveform, on the base of the transistor, the most sensitive, etc. So I turn the trimmer now. Well, I do that with my hand, and you can see that the waveform deteriorates and stops on a certain moment. So there is a critical position somewhere on the trimmer where the whole circuit oscillates. The best value for the voltage supply is 9 volts. I've tested that. The waveform is at its best. And well, I will now connect the battery instead of the power supply on the workbench. That will take some time, of course. Well, this is the battery. Now connect it to a battery. And I connect my scope again, and the counter, of course, I need two hands to do that. And the counter is here. Counter. And let's see what's happening. Of course, this battery is healthy, it's full. I've measured it, it's 9 volts, 9.2 volts, 9.3 volts approximately. And here is the waveform again. And here we have the frequency out. And the by tuning the tremor, I can search for the position where the waveform is at its most pure form. This is approximately here. This is a good waveform. 701 hertz. The frequency is very critical, the bias is very critical, and it has everything to do with the properties of sine wave oscillators. There's much theory on the World Wide Web about sine wave oscillators and on my YouTube channel, where you go to the Looking Glass and do the keyword sine or sine wave or sine wave oscillator, you will find many more schematics of sine wave oscillators. Thanks for watching. This was all. You can change the frequency somewhat by changing the value of these three capacitors. They always must be identical. You can, for instance, take 50 nanofarad instead of 100 nanofarad. Then the frequency will go up. And on the highest frequencies, say above 10 kilohertz, kilocycles, this must be a ceramic capacitor. Otherwise, it doesn't work.